front.
What is co-latitude?
Co-latitude, same latitude. First do this. No, co-latitude is something else. It's a complementary angle of a given latitude. 90 minus latitude angle.
So is it pushing? So is that the 4 pi r square r2 cube by t square r1 square?
Did you get this? Latitude is a complementary angle of, sorry, co-latitude is a complementary angle of the latitude, 90 minus latitude angle.
So can you draw it?
Ye lai. Ye earth hai, ye satellite hai, okay? So basically this angle is a co-latitude angle. This is the equatorial plane, this is the latitude angle. First one, how many of you got it? First one, only 2, 3.
So what's co-latitude?
Did you get this? Then forget about that. First focus here. The radius of a planet is R1 and satellite revolves around it in a circle of radius R2. The time of revolution is T. I think this is simple.
Yes.
So mass of the satellite V square by R2 is equal to G mass of the planet M divided by R2 square. So you'll get velocity to be equal to root over Gm by R2 and 2 pi R2 by V is the time period. Basically mass of the planet is not given to us. Okay, acceleration due to gravity for the planet just like Earth will be Gm divided by R1 square. So get the mass of planet by substituting value of velocity over here. In terms of T, you get M and then substitute here. You'll get the value of G. Same thing you guys have done?
Yes.
Okay.
Is it 4T by T squared into R2 cube by R1
square? 4 pi I, square.
Four? Yes, and I approximated pi square equals 10.
Ah, it is 10. 4 pi square R2 Q divided by T square R1 square.
So the next one, sine is 64 by 3.
Sine
was 0.15. So do you just put like the height of the geostationary planet?
See, guys, listen here, all of you. Geostationary satellite, geostationary satellite will be where? Will be somewhere here, right? It will be in the plane of the rotation that you have discussed. It will rotate like that. Are you getting it? Getting it or not? Right? So once it gives out signal, it will only give out signal here and there. It can't give signal beyond this. It can't give signal from here till there. Yes or no? It can give signal only from here till there. Signals can't cross the earth and reach here. Fine? So there is a significance to this angle. Okay? And this angle is called co-latitude angle. Isko C likh do. Okay? And this angle is latitude angle, lambda it is, okay, and this is 90 degree, so lambda plus c is 90 degree. Ab bol kya bol raha tha?
So for the geostationary satellite, why can't it go about a different diameter of axis?
We discussed it, no? Yes, last class we have discussed it.
So, you know, we discussed why it has to be about the diameter, but not why it has to be perpendicular to the rotation axis of Earth.
We discussed that also. It has to be along this plane. If it has to be, if you're telling me like this here, it can't rotate like this.
No, sir, but why can't it rotate from that point about...
Like that?
Yeah.
But Earth is rotating like this, no?
Why will that change anything?
Why not? Earth is rotating like this, and your satellite is rotating like that. So how can you be above the same point? You have to rotate with the Earth.
Okay, so but it'll still work, right?
No, like it won't work.
No, no, sir, listen, it won't be geostationary, but that satellite can still exist, right?
Hi, it can exist. You can throw an object, it will rotate like that. No problem. But geostationary satellite will only lie in the plane of the equatorial. Like that. Getting it? So we need to find this angle, basically. How will you find that angle? Radius of Earth is given. What else is given?
And we know the height.
Yeah, we know the height.
We know the height of the geostationary satellites. This H is given, and this is R anyways. So hypotenuse is given, R is given. So sine of co-latitude is R divided by R plus H. Do you know what is H?
35,800.
So you can find out. Sine of critical comes out to be 0.15. Sine of co-latitude. Okay, I'm giving you 15 minutes to complete both of them. Get the answer, okay? Lot of time I'm giving you. Get the answer.
So is that 5?
I am not asking you to speak. Please solve quietly and keep quiet once you get it. All of you attempt it.
So is it 8 kilometers per second?
Hmm. All of you should get the answer. See, if you remember few things like escape velocity 2GRE is 11.2 kilometers per second, you can use this expression directly. You can compare whatever you have with these values and get the answer. You don't have to substitute G and M again.
No, it's 5.6.
Sir, is the first one 8 kilometers per second and the second one 10 kilometers per second?
All of you do this. All of you should get the answer. 6,400 kilometers is the radius also. Okay, so it goes a maximum height of the radius of the Earth. Okay? So U1 plus K1 is equal to U2 plus K2. Shh. U1 is what? Stop talking. GMM by R. This is U1 at the Earth surface. Plus kinetic energy half M into V square. This is equal to U2 minus of GMM by what?
2R.
Plus 0, small m get cancelled away. So velocity will come out to be how much?
11.
Are you formula here? What are you getting here? Root over gm by r. So under root 2 gm by r is 11.2. So answer is 11.2 divided by root 2. Right? Which is roughly 7.9 kilometers per second. 11.2 divided by root 2. You don't have to substitute what is G, what is ME and all that. You already know this value, escape velocity. Getting it? Now do the second one also. Always use these values. The value of G is GME by RE square. This is 9.8. You have to use these values. Okay? Usually you never have to substitute what is capital G in mass of Earth. You can always use the already known values to get the answer.
So the second one is approximately 10 kilometers per second.
10? 10 approx. Interstellar space. Yes, 10. Okay, it is fired with 15 km per second, which is higher than the escape velocity. So it will go to infinity and still have some kinetic energy. If you fire with the escape velocity at infinity, its kinetic energy becomes zero. That is how we derived it. Okay? So U1 plus K1, where K1 is half m v square plus U1 g mm by Re. This is equal to potential energy is zero at infinity plus kinetic energy half m v1 square. So v1 will come out to be root over v square minus 2g m by Re. Now how you proceed with this? I know that v square is how much?
15 square.
This 15 square and this is how much?
11.2 square.
And this is what? A plus B and A minus B? 15 minus 11.2 into 15 plus 11.2. Just look at roughly, this is 100, root over 100 is roughly 10. So you need to understand these tricks. Don't be like a fool, so start substituting G and M and Re here and...
Should
it
be
Kf
per second?
What?
Kf per second.
Km per second, I'm used to writing Km per hour. Okay, last question of Hcoma. We have done entire Hcoma sitting here in just 3 hours. So, it is not that you have lack of time. Less than 3 hours, 2.5 hours. It's not lack of time which is stopping you. It is your attention which is, focus attention which is lacking. Not lack of time. Entire Hcoma we have done. Solve this.
So this is Schwarzschild radius.
Yeah, this is Schwarzschild radius.
Jo bhi radius hai, nikalo kitna hai. So it's a black hole. Even light can't escape.
So -3 meters.
This is the last question. Don't make silly error in the last question.
So is it 8004 meters?
Kilometers.
So is it 14.2 into 10 to the power minus 10 meters?
So is it 8.8 into 10 to the power minus 3?
Say yes, I got that.
To 8 bola na?
So no, sir, it's 8.8.
Jee, good. So Earth has to get compressed to 9 mm. That's like 0.1 centimeter radius sphere to become a black hole. Same mass should be condensed to 0.1 centimeter radius sphere. It's not. Are you able to get it?
Yes.
Get the answer. Not only Earth, all the people living in and all the plants and animals, everybody should get compressed. Okay. Do you think as people are getting born, the mass of Earth is increasing?
No.
It's remain constant. It's all redistribution of the mass that is happening. So all the elements from one place, whatever people eat, all that get transformed into a life. Like a person get born, died. Again, all the minerals get dissolved in the five elements, they say, right? Panch Tattva. Then again, they'll recombine to create a human. Okay, so most of you have not got it.
Yeah,
how many of you got it?
Okay,
so escape velocity formula is what? Root 2 g m divided by the radius, right? This has to be equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8. Right now, if you put R as radius of Earth, it was 11.2. Okay, so you can say that 2 g m e divided by radius of Earth it was 11.2 kilometers per second, so 1.1 into 10 is power 4. So now divide it. So root over RE by R is equal to 3 divided by 1.1 into 10 raised to the power 4. Okay? 3 divided by 1.1? 3. So R by RE, 1.1 this 10 raised to the power minus 4 square. This much meters. Oh, I have to multiply the radius of Earth to get R. Correct. Yes, I am correct. So R is 1.21 by 9 into 10 is so minus 8, 6.4 into 10 is power 6. Okay, you don't have to put the value of G and ME. Again, we can avoid that. But if there is a lack of problem practice, you will put it. Fine, so these are the questions from these from this chapter. They are all mains level. Okay. So advanced level we could not do.